We continue our series of interviews looking at the emerging oil and gas industry. Our guest tonight is the MP for NAPDAM. He's also the chairman of the Parliamentary Sub-Committee on Energy. We'll be examining the state of the laws of work with regard to the legal framework in the industry. We'll be examining issues of revenue, sharing, the fiscal regime, and a whole range of things that really show that this country is ready for production in the last quarter of 2010. Mr. Moses Asaga, thank you for coming.
Thank you also for inviting me.
Mr. Asaga, tell me, as chairman of the Parliamentary Subcommittee on Energy, what kind of legal framework do you have in place to guide the development of this emerging industry?
First of all, the Parliamentary Subcommittee on Energy is responsible to the Ministry of Energy. And then we have oversight responsibilities over GNPC, Tema Oil Refinery, and BOST, and all affiliated energy agencies. But when you come specifically to the oil and gas, where you are talking about upstream for now, I think that the main agency is GNPC, then we have the Ministry for Energy. Regarding the legislature and the laws that we operate in, I think a number of the good laws were promulgated in the mid-80s. So we have the GNPC law, 85 or 84. And then we also have the petroleum law about the same period. Then we also have the taxation. And then we have the model agreement, which came in by 2000. So these are the
laws that guide
the petroleum sector, especially the upstream, because we have different acts for the downstream, and then the midstream will soon be coming up with legislation. So based on these laws, Parliament is able to do its work. And as far as the oil and gas is concerned, GNPC is our main target group. And anytime there is an application for exploration and production, after GNPC have done all the necessary technical work, the agreements are brought to Parliament. And then we would have to look at, one, the company that has applied for a block in Ghana. We need to know their technical capability. After that, we'll have to look at their financial capability, their experiences worldwide, but in particular in West Africa. Since most of the basins and geological formations are similar, we need to know whether they have that kind of experience. And even more so, now that we are talking about deep water, you have to have a deep water experience offshore. And those are the issues we look at. But again, being the representatives of Ghana and having oversight responsibility on expenditure and revenue of Ghana, we also look at the fiscal regime in the contract. And the fiscal regime would be, what would be the government take? What benefit would Ghanaians get out of that particular agreement? And I think as far as the fiscal structure is concerned, you are looking at royalties. You are looking at additional oil entitlement based on the rate of return of that particular project or field. You are looking at the 35% corporate tax. Then maybe, in addition, the equity participation of GNPC, which is in the law. And most important, the 10% carried interest of GNPC, where we pay nothing for exploration and production, but that amount just comes to GNPC, to Ghana government.
Mr. Asaga, most of the laws that govern the operations of the oil and gas, the petroleum, if you like, industry, were established in the 80s. Are they not outdated?
I think substantially they are still very relevant, but with technology and other fiscal situations, we need to improve upon them. And that is why the government is looking at the Petroleum Regulatory Authority, which would then harmonize the petroleum agreement, look at the GNPC law, the taxation, and then the model agreement. So efforts are being made, and I know in the next 30 days, we should be getting a Petroleum Regulatory Authority law. We should be getting other laws that would have fine-tuned and harmonized these 1980s laws. So that is the effort that is going on. But in terms of contract content, and then the policy of giving out blocks. I think that one, we need to amend the laws, because initially, because we had a geological risk, which was very high, we made sure that it was an open door policy where GNPC and the Ministry of Energy received applications from potential international oil companies.
But now you found the oil.
But now that we have found the oil,
yes,
Ghana has now been the risk, and there are a lot of applications. And I think that to be able to improve the value of our assets in monetary terms, we probably need to start what we call the licensing rounds or bidding rounds. Now, because we didn't have an experience with that, I think that part of the regulations would need to capture how the bidding rounds or the licensing rounds have to be done.
For example, open, transparent processes?
Yes.
Or quiet assignment of blocks?
I think it will be open, transparent processes, yeah, and even the demarcation of the blocks.
But is the fiscal regime in place properly, or are we still, you know, fidgeting with it? And, you know, I mean, I ask you this because, yes, sometimes there's the fear that we are not ready.
I think that the fiscal regime that I'm talking about now is the economics of,
yes,
it,
yes,
and what government is supposed to take.
Yes, is, and that in,
and
place?
That one is in place, because I had already quoted to you,
yes,
the various numbers.
Yes.
You know, because we have a royalty of at about 10%, carried interest of about 10%.
Are you happy with that? I mean,
I think so far we are happy, because at the end of it, you try to aggregate all of it and look at what is the government take. And once you are making a government take of 55% and above, I think that you are doing very well.
55%
of the total oil revenue that would come from a production.
Is that how much we get as a country?
Yes, that is what we are going to get. And even it's going to be better. And it varies from contract to contract. Previous contracts were getting maybe 45, 50, but the new contracts that we have recently ratified, we are almost hitting 65%.
So we're asking for more and more as
we
go along.
We're asking for more.
But that is what I'm saying. Is that
not
the risk?
Yes, but we are asking for more and more, but bearing in mind other regional government takes in other countries.
Yes.
I mean, in other countries, it's as high as 90%. And we think that our 55 to 65 is quite an optimum number as government.
But exploration is expensive.
Yeah.
And development of the fields is expensive. We don't have the resources to do it, do we?
We don't.
And so if you don't, then how do you manage, therefore, to be the biggest beneficiary?
Well, I think that there are sovereign resources. And the oil and gas belongs to Ghana.
Yeah.
And therefore, the international oil company have this at the back of their minds, that they are coming to do business. But they shouldn't do business where Ghana government and the good people of Ghana would be at a disadvantage. So there's the industry practice, right from the Gulf of Mexico to Venezuela, to the North Sea,
etc. But as you imagine, they would also
I think that so far, they are happy with their take in Ghana.
The oil company.
Yes, they are very happy with their take in Ghana. Mm. And even for others, when you push them a bit, they are willing to, because in Venezuela, for example, an international oil company take could only be